MCRD San Diego Building 622 receiving company. You understand?
Yes, sir.
From now on, the only words coming out of your mouth will be yes, sir. No, sir. Yes, sir. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Tens of thousands of Marines have begun their outstanding service on these very yellow footprints.
You
will carry out that proud tradition to your extent.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Scream it.
Yes, sir.
You have just taken your first steps in becoming members of the world's finest fighting force, the United States Marine Corps.
These recruits are entrusted to my care. I will train them to the best of my ability. I will develop them into. Smartly disciplined.
Physically fit.
Basically trained Marines. Thoroughly indoctrinated.
In love with foreign country.
I will demand of them. And demonstrate by my own example.
The highest standards.
Personal conduct.
Rally.
And professional skill.
Take charge of these men and make them Marines.
Recruit training. So this week we covered McNabb. We also did the Bayonet Assault Force. And we get the recruits ready to transition on to second phase. So it's more demanding with the hike and running. And as you see now, we're doing the obstacle course. They run it twice. That way they get ready to the physical demands.
There's a full of crunches, the ammo can lifts.
And we get the recruits ready to transition on to second phase.
So right now we're doing the combat fitness test.
It's two laps, you understand?
Yes, sir.
Ready? Go.
You know, measuring their strength, see how they're performing on that.
Get up! Run!
Crawl.
It's important for the recruits to experience because this is their first time in recruit training. This is the first time they're learning about the Marines. And for us to throw this on them and have them train like this, it gets in their mindset that this is, you know, it's not just about them anymore. It's not me, it's us. It's about Marines, brotherhood. We also have the senior drill instructor inspection. Basically, we get to see their attention to detail as far as their uniforms, as far as their cleanliness of weapons, and just the knowledge that we've instilled in them since the moment they picked up on us in Foxhole.
Every Marine is a rifleman, but also Marines are amphibious. That's a 25-meter swim. The 4-minute float. The drop from the tower. To turn you, overcome your fear of heights. But also initial PFT, test your strength as well as pull-ups. Crunches and then 3-mile run.
Hi, sir.
Pack up the food in the house and we move up to Camp Pelton, which moves into the second phase, which is rifle marksmanship.
So for grass week, we have the recruits for 5 days and they get taught about the basic fundamentals of marksmanship. A lot of these guys have never even like held a weapon or anything, so it's all the way from how they handle that weapon in a safe manner to placing well-aimed shots in the center of a target up to 500 yards. So the firing position, so there's the prone, sitting, kneeling, and standing, and then we teach them every variation. We find what variation works for them, and then we take that, we practice it for that week so they can go down range and apply it. ISMIT, so it's indoor simulated marksmanship training. They use that to simulate shooting down range, and it gives the recruits an idea of sort of what to expect.
The recruits are in grass week with a 5-mile hike.
Marine Division,
sir.
This week is our table one relay for the recruits. Many of the recruits, this is their first time ever actually firing a live round. They're taking everything that they did last week, learning how to aim, the proper shot placement, proper stances, proper positions and holds, and they're actually applying that to live rounds this week. They fire all day long. Multiple days before they actually qualify. Every recruit will have a coach standing over them that is willing to help them out and turn them into the marksmen that we need them to be as Marines. The goal of every Marine is to become a rifleman, to become proficient with their weapon, and that's what we're doing here. Before they leave out of here, they will be a rifleman first and foremost.
So this week, Fox Company had field week. Started the week off, table two shooting, which is that close quarter combat shooting. We worked on all those drills that PMI taught, those tactical reloads, speed reloads, control pairs through the chest, stop drills. They were put in that combat mindset, and they went out there and they accomplished their mission they were assigned to do.
Downrange area is clear.
Then they went to the field for their basic warrior training. They went out there and they did this assault course where they practiced low light drills with flares in the air, combat gliding, and how to properly overcome obstacles in the combat territory with the combat mindset. Then they started learning land navigation, how to read a map, how to plot points on a map, and how to find those points they plotted. They worked on it during the day and at night.
Team week is first week of third phase. This is a week where we start really transitioning and giving the recruits the responsibilities of taking care of each other, doing the right thing when nobody's watching. They go to different agencies and they just help out, breaking boxes down, cleaning up, stocking shelves, whatever needs to get done around the depot. Also this week we have an interior guard showing the recruits the purpose of standing duty in a more real life situation. The drill instructors also do scenarios. For example, if somebody comes out the area of operation and the recruits get challenged with tasks like that. The series commander's inspection is an inspection done by a series commander, and what he's looking for basically is for them to be able to articulate themselves, talk with confidence, demonstrate bearing. It's preparation for company commander's inspection and the battalion commander's inspection.
This week, Fox Company did the inventory PFT, measures the fitness of the recruits since they've been here at recruit training. It's about their middle point, measure their pull-ups, crunches, and run time, see how much improvement they made. Did the bayonet assault course, where they go through, they can put their McMap techniques that they learned to the test in a real-life scenario. The final Beagle 6 in the Thunderdome, where they'll be doing the final CFT. The CFT is a combat fitness test. They measure their the amount of times they're able to lift a 30-pound ammo can. They do a obstacle course that consists of carrying ammo cans, zigzagging through obstacles, low crawling, high crawling, sprinting, and doing a fireman's carry. They also do a 880-meter sprint around the track.
So this week, we actually had our final drill. This is a big thing for the recruits. This actually shows them a lot of pride and discipline. And a lot of things that the drill instructors actually worked hard for to do.
In the final PFT, physical fitness test, where recruits are evaluated on pull-ups, crunches, and a run time.
Next thing that we're going to be doing this week is the rappel tower. The rappel tower for the recruits is the opportunity for them to get their last little bit of courage out and show the drill instructors that they actually want to be United States Marines.
On the depot is the most challenging week of training and starts with a confidence chamber. The chamber is filled with CS gas, a non-lethal tear gas and riot control agent, and tests the recruit's knowledge on properly employing equipment used during biological and chemical attacks. The remainder of week 12 is spent undergoing the most defining moment of recruit training, the Crucible. The Crucible is the culminating event of recruit training process. It is a 54-hour field training exercise executed with only 3 meals and 4 hours of sleep per night, designed to emphasize the importance of teamwork and overcoming adversity. The Crucible culminates with a formal presentation of the Eagle, Globe, and Anchor, and officially marks the transition from recruit to Marine.
We are proud to claim the title of United States Marines.
So this week, Fox Company is on Marine Week. On Tuesday, the new Marines conducted the Battalion Commander's Inspection. The Battalion Commander's Inspection is the final inspection the new Marines will face while aboard the depot. The inspection evaluates the Marines' bearing, knowledge, uniforms, weapon cleanliness, and it provides the Battalion Commander the time to talk to the new Marines and get an insight of their personal experiences throughout recruit training. On Thursday, the new Marines will have the motivational run. The final physical training event together as a company, the new Marines will have the opportunity to be granted 5 hours to spend with their loved ones while before graduating the following day. Friday is the last day in recruit training, their graduation. It's the last event for the Marines where the company honormen are recognized and platoon guidons are retired to symbolize the disbanding of the platoons.